Okay, so I'm gonna have a few things tonight. I was talking about boycotting Asia, in specific, like the whole side of the planet, because of their tactics have just not stopped with the animal abuses, the continuance of ridicules, circuses, showpieces, disgusting habits of eating animals, companion animals, etc., 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 the dog markets, and so forth. The only way I believe we can really hurt them is to not buy their products. Stop buying as much as you can from China. Stop buying as much as you can from anywhere that eats dogs. Just don't buy from there. Don't buy rice anymore from there. Buy rice from France. You know what I'm saying? You have to make those decisions. And that's not really what I wanted to talk about. It's such a drag. It's like talk about retrograde. It's like the whole half of the planet is just thrust into this dark hole, black hole of just heinous cruelties and suffrages to animals. Just non-stop. Who cares about your airplanes that go there? Who wants to be there? How horrible a condolence. You know, I have like no racial qualms with Asians at all, but the pacifists that allow that going on in their own countries and they go off to work each day, my God, who are you? Yeah, a very, very horrible, dealing with a very horrible, you know. You say the others, they're the others. They are the ones that, they're heinous. Aside from what they do to women, hey, let's have another war because all of the white dudes over here are bored and they want subservient women again. You know, I am so sick of that. You know, the subservient, needy male. He's subservient to that want. Yeah. You know, he can't have an equal. He has to have a woman who is his for sure. His underdog. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, forget that. That's nothing. That is nothing in comparison to what I'm talking about, what they're doing to these animals. When I'm talking about the cruelty level and the condoning of it, they don't deserve money. They do not deserve money. They do not deserve a penny out of your paycheck. They don't deserve a penny out of your savings. They don't deserve any money. Why would you buy from there? In the old days, I bought a Toyota, you know. And I'm like, what an idiot. What an idiot I was. I don't care if it was a good car and it lasted a long time. What an idiot. And I'm like, well, that's Japan. You know, they're not so bad. Doesn't matter. They're still trade happy with China. They're still trade happy with all these others along that little aisle there. You know, all of these little agreements, you know, nobody's making a statement saying, that's it, I don't even do business with you anymore. That's it. Enough. Just enough. You do not deserve it. You understand? You're not worthy. There reaches a point when you're just not worthy. You have not come up to snuff. You have not relegated yourself to a higher power of this year 2018. You haven't made it. You understand? You have not made it. So you don't get to play. Very simple. No. You just say no. No more. Not buying from that crap anymore. Not buying from that crappy junk anymore. Those crappy countries. And they're doling out whatever they want to dole out in the streets. Really, and I'm talking food supply. Stop ingesting from them. Stop ingesting food supply from there. That means tea. Your beautiful green tea. You have to get it from somewhere else. No rice, no green tea. Yeah, they've tried to bring over plums, everything. No more food from Asia until this is sorted out. That's it. It's just as simple as that. On a human scale, you're human. So you can wake up each day and you don't feel... Well, you'll feel the grind and the hurt and the pain inside that they're doing, but you won't be feeding them to future their livelihoods. Do you understand? You just will not be futuring their livelihood on a personal scale. And that is something. You know, a little person out there, that is something. I just have so much, like, I mean, we have the USDA that is, what? Just allowing just these heinous experiments here in the United States to go on? The USDA. Write them a letter. I wrote them a letter. You can write them a letter also. It's regulations.gov. Write them a letter. Tell them to stop. Tell them to stop. Tell them that they have an ethical, a moral and ethical responsibility as a governing factor of our United States. They have that moral and ethical responsibility to not condone cruelty to animals, to not allow these heinous experiments to go on, to not allow suffrage. They have that responsibility. They're supposed to be the inspectors. They're supposed to be the inspectors and say, you're a no. Your company is a no. You are not allowed to do that, ever. You're out of business. They have that right. They are there as supposed to be the head honchos to say no. We need them to speak up. We need them to be adults. Come on. This is a serious, serious job they have. This is not something that is just so frivolous. I got out of college. I joined the USDA. This is a serious job. This is one of authority. This is one of ethics. This is one that involves responsibility over sentient animals, over their keep, over their protection. Yeah, so shame on you, USDA, for allowing the continuance of these horrible experiments. The white bunny, I want him freed. I want that white bunny freed. Anyway, yeah, the white bunny, yeah, we know there's many, but that one was a very poignant photo, very good photography. Captured him. I mean, he wasn't hiding. The bunny rabbit was not hiding from his existence. He was telling in his eyes, in his spirit, in his body posture, he was telling you how horrible his life was. He was not hiding. All right, well, yeah, I wanted to talk about retrograde, and it just seems to be animal cruelty is hitting just too hard here on this planet. There are just too many bad people. What is this power trip they have over animals? Just too many bad people. Anyway, same thing with all these women running out and gathering their makeup, you know, still that animal testing. You know, do not buy from that company that animal tests. Really. Try to go to those health food stores as much as you can, and buy those healthiest ingredients as much as you can. Buy those most organic ingredients. I hate to say it, the fruits are twice the price. But, you know, when you have 70 pesticides present in a cantaloupe, I mean, you buy the organic. You just have to buy the organic of everything that is a fruit and everything that is a vegetable. Or else, what? Your pesticide wear? You know, pesticide wear, the intake of the cockroach itself. You know, so you become just another one, another cockroach, one that it tries to adapt and tries to adapt and tries to adapt to the next life level. No, that's not cool. We don't want pesticide cockroach generational human beings, do we? That's not a stronger human. I can already see, you know, the pesticide wear and what it does inside their brains. I can already see how it hurts and disturbs and destroys their basic matriculations. You already know what pesticides are up to. Heavy metal. You know, we're talking about heavy metal. Like, you know, we're talking about here's a planet, metal, that's moving this way, and all of a sudden you're feeling a little weird. We're talking heavy metal inside your own body. So you're messing up with everything. You're just messing up with everything. Anyway, sorry for this video. It's just awful. I just had an awful day at that stupid dog market Eureka or whatever. I can't even say it. I'm so upset. And yet, I don't know. If you were next to me, you know, my country, and your country was next to me, and you were doing that, pulling those maneuvers, no, I never trade with you until you change, modify, upgrade, become one with this new 2018 and who we are. A responsible country. One that does not condone suffrage. And that includes the United States. That includes the United States, it includes France. Your tiny little laboratories hidden away in small provincial towns. That includes France. All right. Anyway, I have nothing to say more.